So let's dive into Math Techbook through the lens of one of our games, Shapeshifter. In Shapeshifter, students apply patterns in a game setting. This leads to an arithmetic sequence that will guide them to discover other sequences of this sort. This is one of the core foundational concepts within Algebra 2. As the students move on to analyze the data, I have to ask, does this look like math textbooks you're familiar with? No, not really? Well, good, that's exactly our point. Our goal is to make math fun and relevant to our students. We've leveraged the power of digital and created an environment that's colorful and highly interactive. We use situations that students would actually find interesting, whether that's playing cards, or perhaps it's the zombie apocalypse. I can't claim that's real life, but it might be something that they're interested in. Their favorite books, or even roller coaster design. Many other scenarios that excite the students. So every math teacher knows the importance of connecting math to the real world. To answer that question of, why do I need to know this? At Discovery Education, we weave real-world examples throughout the entire math tech book, beginning with the unit opener video.
You know that kite you're flying is attached to 200 feet of string, but how high off the ground is it? What size flat-screen TV should you buy? Is that shortcut really a shortcut? Each of these situations involves a right triangle. It may not always be obvious, but it's there. And knowing something about the relationship of the sides of a right triangle will help you answer these questions.
Having a deep and wide pool of real-world examples is just the beginning. Math Techbook was built on the three pillars of math rigor: conceptual understanding, procedural skill and fluency, and application. These pillars align to the Common Core, as well as state standards, and are frankly excellent math practice. At Discovery Education, our instructional framework is called the DPA cycle, or Discover, Practice, and Apply. And these align to the three pillars. So what makes this unique? We start by building a deep conceptual understanding. Students are in the driver's seat, exploring and investigating, discovering their answer on their own, but with teacher support. We don't give them the formula up front. Students then move on to the practice section to work on their procedural fluency based on the concepts they just investigated. And finally, we end with the apply section, where students apply what they've learned to real-world situations. So let's start with the D, discover, where students begin their math experience. The discover section is built on a series of investigations for each concept, laid out in a logical sequence that builds on prior learning. And we believe that math is not a spectator sport. We get students involved in doing immediately. Students are often greeted with an interactive, and interactives are inherently awesome. And so in this particular one, they have a choice. They can investigate caffeine, aspirin, or taurine, all of which leave the body at different rates. They can select from one of three different amounts of each chemical, so that's nine different contexts to consider. They see a graph, a clock, a vertical representation of how much chemical is left in the body, and an algebraic function. Coupled with the text on screen, that's five different mathematical ways to represent the same situation. Students then have to identify the numbers for the function. So they start to realize how the initial amount of the chemical and its half-life affect the graph and the function. You'll see when they get the function to match the graph, as the lines move closer together as they're exploring, the dots are going to blink, giving them that immediate feedback that the answer is correct. There's no need for them to stop, flip to the back of the book, remember what page they're on, find the question and find the answer. They get that immediate feedback. Moving on to the P section in the DPA cycle, practice. This is where students work on their procedural skills and fluency. They are challenged to solve problems based on the conceptual understanding they developed in the discover section. Practice is made up of coach and play exercises. A coach is a highly scaffolded area where students get a whole lot of direct feedback based on their answers. If the answer is incorrect, instant and actionable feedback is provided. When a student gets an answer right, a green check mark appears indicating so. This enables the student to monitor their own progress. Students continue to practice in the play section. In the play area, students are ready to complete exercises on their own. This is where they can do independent practice and figure out how much they know and how much they still need to learn. Questions use the same technology-enhanced item types as PARC and Smarter Balanced, so students gain confidence answering the types of questions they'll see on state and national assessments. You're going to see a gamification element here, and it's based on research. It's an additive model where students are rewarded with badges for the right answers, but they're not penalized for the wrong ones. Finally, the A in the DPA cycle, apply, where we give students what we call the problems we're solving. In these real-world scenarios, students move from the how to the why, and they justify their answer with explanations. Every concept has apply problems, and every apply problem has a digital rubric. Teachers love the digital rubric. It saves them time as they're grading the student work, and it gives them qualitative feedback to provide the students. Now that I've walked you through the DPA model, I'd like to show you the powerful information that we make available to teachers so that they can help adjust their instruction along the way to meet the needs of every student. Techbook collects data all along the student's journey through Discover, Practice, and Apply, and displays it in real time in the dashboard. Individual student names can be displayed, or if students are working in groups, group names can be shown. Teachers can also choose to hide the student names and use the assessment data for learning by having the students analyze and discuss the answers displayed. This data allows teachers to answer key questions such as, does my whole class grasp this concept? Are we ready to move on to practice? Do I need to focus on a group of students or maybe an individual? Teachers crave this kind of information so they don't have to wait until a unit test or some other summative assessment. They have real-time data at their fingertips to make real-time instructional decisions. We've given you just a little bit of the teacher wow factor, but I want to go back and talk a little bit more about the student wow factor. Math Techbook includes a number of built-in tools like a digital whiteboard and a geometry tool and a graphing calculator and several others. These just-in-time tools are available on every page. Let's take a quick look at the graphing calculator, where students learn about the translation of graphs by choosing a function and explore using the sliders, which represent the values for the variables in that function. We've embedded the tools into a number of our pre-existing activities, but students can also use them from scratch to explore whatever, whenever they like. With all of our tools, students can take a screenshot with a built-in camera function and submit it to their teacher as evidence. Students can also upload their custom creations to their personal My Content folder as a file to be opened later. These are the types of tools that get students excited. They're taking control of their own learning, all while reinforcing their math skills and understanding. As I wrap up the demo portion of our presentation, I want to make mention of the important role of professional development in any successful math program implementation. We embed professional development resources throughout the Math Techbook itself, and we also work hand-in-hand with districts to create an in-person professional development plan that works with their specific needs. We believe that Math Techbook can fundamentally change the math experience for teachers and students. For teachers, it's an all-in-one resource that's instructionally driven. It's a comprehensive solution at their fingertips that helps them to save time, make it easier to gauge student progress, and to differentiate instruction with all the real-world examples they could imagine. For students, Math Techbook brings math to life with the problems we're solving, with multiple pathways and modalities for them to learn, practice, and apply. It keeps them engaged with scenarios that interest them. Math Techbook will help motivate students to step up. Even the most hesitant of learners will be drawn in. And as we know, sometimes drawing them in is half the battle. They'll collaborate, they'll investigate, they'll explore and analyze. They'll work on real-world messy problems, and they'll get things wrong. But they'll learn to persevere and improve. And in the end, students will build the lasting proficiency they need to be successful in math, and that will extend far beyond the classroom walls.